keep the party polite. Never get out of my sight. Stick with me, baby, I'm the guy that you came in with. Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady. Luck be a lady.
Hey guys, so it's me, Gastric Bypass Barbie. Just got back from Vegas. I got to go to the ASMBS conference and I had an awesome time, as you saw by the first two videos about the Travelodge and the Aria Hotel. But that's not what I want to talk to you about right now. A lot of people have been asking, what the heck is the ASMBS and can I go? So I figured I should probably demystify it a little bit for you guys. Let me begin by telling you that the ASMBS is a professional organization, and it is its membership is doctors, healthcare professionals, practitioners, people like bariatric coordinators, nurses, dietitians, nutritionists, mental health professionals, basically anybody who's in the medical field in any way, shape, or form who needs to help bariatric patients, people with obesity. Those are the kind of peoples that are members of this society. But what does ASMBS stand for, you ask? Well, how about the American Society for Metabolic and Bariatric Surgery? Interestingly enough, that little letter M for metabolic wasn't always in the title. That's something they added a few years back when they learned that bariatric surgery actually affects the metabolism. So, it used to be the ASBS. Anyway, they've been around for a lot of years, like since 1983, and this was the 27th annual conference. Now, why did I go, you ask, if it's not really for bariatric patients? Well, I went because I was trying to shine the spotlight on aftercare education and explain to them how poor it is as a rule. I mean, it's horrible. You know, the kind of care that we tend to get, I don't know about you, but like weight loss surgery for dummies. Is my hair going to fall out? Do I have to take protein forever? Do I have to take my vitamins and supplements? What kind should I take? Stuff like, do I have to exercise? Okay. You know what? The rest of our lives is way more than just those kinds of questions. And those things are typically, traditionally not being answered. And you know what? Unfortunately, a lot of doctors don't realize that there is a huge vacuum, a huge black hole where valuable bariatric aftercare education should be taking place. So that's why I was there, because I'm pretty passionate about it, as you know. I wanted these doctors and professionals to see a real, live, living and breathing, successful and happy and healthy bariatric patient. Because you know what? A lot of times the only time they see you is when you're asleep on the operating table and then for your annual checkups. And they look at your labs. And if you're lucky enough to even see a doctor, by the way, you might just be seeing the physician's assistant. So they don't really connect with the patients. That's why I was there. Now, I got to go with Antonia Namnath, who is the founder of WLSFA, which stands for the Weight Loss Surgery Foundation of America. And she was there shining the spotlight on the terrific, tremendous needs of people who are obese but don't have the benefit of insurance companies that are willing to pay for bariatric surgery or medically necessary reconstructive surgery where, you know, quality of life is being affected. And so she wanted to bring this attention of the organization to the healthcare professionals, doctors, mental health professionals, etc. So that's why we were there. Basically, we were a couple of bariatric patients. We were there representing, I guess you could say. So It is actually designed more for doctors because they have lots of seminars, lots of big lectures and talks that pertain to the current state of affairs for bariatric surgery and the kinds of tools that are being marketed, stuff like that. So, you know, you had your people like Allergan there, the people that make the lap band, and you saw a lot of the tools for the laparoscopic surgery, and, you know, that's what it was like. But there were also product people there, and those are the people that we tend to connect with. And I'm talking about the Celebrate Vitamin people, the Bariatric Advantage people, who else? Bariatric Eating, Revival Soy. Well, Shannon from Revival Soy was hanging out with Susan Maria in her booth over at Bariatric Eating. And I also got to meet with Mark and Jennifer from Bariatric Fusion. And oh, as long as I'm name dropping, I hung out with Teresa and Vic and Nick and Ken over at the Celebrate Vitamins booth. And I got to see Jacqueline. She is a little spitfire, that one. Smart as a whip. She is one of the, I don't know, chemists, I guess you could say, the people that help formulate the product for Bariatric Advantage. So I got to hang out with all of those people who were representing valuable products for weight loss surgery patients. I also got to hang out with the people over at Obesity Help. Now, before you say anything, I know Obesity Help has a really bad reputation right now, and it's kind of unfair because it's a really, really large community of people. And unfortunately, I think a lot of us only get exposed to the community boards where we see negative stuff, where we kind of tend to see mean people or misinformation or scary stuff. But you know what? Obesity Help has been around for over 15 years, and they were actually formed for a bigger purpose. I mean, the community boards are just a fraction of what the organization really does. So I'm going to be talking to you guys about the value of Obesity Help in our lives, because when you ask, should I go to the ASMBS conference, I'm going to tell you no, you should go to the Obesity Help conference, because that is actually targeted to bariatric patients, and that's where you're going to get to attend classes, watch, you know, listen to lectures, see even more product. That's the kind of support that we need. Those are the kind of, you know, kinds of conferences that you want to go to. So when you're talking about should you go to ASMBS, no, because you really can't. You have to be sponsored and invited and blah, blah, blah. You have to be a member, and no, it's not for us. You want to go to the Obesity Health conferences. And by the way, there happen to be two more happening this year, first in Cincinnati in August, and the next one and final one in Houston in November. And they have these every year. So that's it for me, guys. I just wanted to let you know the purpose of the ASMBS and let you know a little bit about what I got to do besides sleep in a really cheap motel. And so for the rest of this video, I'm just gonna share pictures with you of my very favorite people. So that's it for me. Next time you hear from me, I'm probably gonna be talking about another wonderful product. So have a great day, you guys. Bye. Oh, viva Las Vegas.
Eternal on a garden neon street.